was on the question that despite knowing Pakistan has all these capabilities, does that mean that the American military leadership is immature? That's not the point. The point is they are mature, but their strings are being pulled from somewhere else, and that place is Tel Aviv. Because we have to note, after I wrote my article, just 2 days after that, in yesterday's news, there was news that the American military leadership has decided that they might consider doing joint Afghan-like raids into Pakistan. This was reported on NavyTimes.com. Now, many of the American leadership has rejected this proposition because they say that in case this happens, not only will Pakistan give a response, even the Afghan freedom fighting forces, they will join in, which will create an inferno in the region. We have to note that America's economy is crumbling day by day. We have the Occupy Wall Street movement. We have the Occupy DC movements. We have the libertarian movements across America, which are demanding defense cuts. And we have Mr. Panetta consistently reiterating that we need more defense budget to expand our operations, especially in the Asia-Pacific region. Now, why they're doing it is also another point to focus on. We have the Israeli aerospace industry, which is doing its largest defense deal with India, worth $1.1 billion, in which they are planning to purchase surveillance equipment to monitor the borders with Pakistan. This is a direct involvement of Israel to engage India in intelligence reconnaissance across the Pakistan-India border. On the Western front, we have Afghan militants that are staging terrorist attacks on Pakistani checkposts. The American leadership has been consistently saying that the ISI is probably supporting the Haqqani network, this and that. The question arises that if the Haqqani network is being supported by ISI, then who is killing the ISI and Pakistan Army soldiers in the Salalah checkpost, etc.? This is being done by Western forces. Does Israel not know that Pakistan can give a proper response? Does Israel not know that Pakistan, although it has not tested its ICBM, it does have 3 major ICBMs in its stockpile, which can reach till Tel Aviv? The American military knows this. And that is why a few weeks ago, there was news that USS Enterprise, which is an American aircraft carrier, it passed by through Pakistan's waters, which in the city of Gwadar, the coastal city. Some speculated that this aircraft carrier was probably going towards Qatar so that it can launch attacks on Iran, which is a high probability because Iran is also under the threat of American imperialism. They wanted to create an impression that Pakistan has actually allowed American forces to operate against Iran, which is a wrong perception, and I'm sure the Iranian leadership is fully aware of this propaganda. Why did the Pakistani forces not react and shoot down the jet on that plane? Because they did not want to provoke war. Pakistan is already facing severe, massive propaganda around the world that, look, we have the Taliban, we have the Al-Qaeda, they can reach on Pakistan's nuclear stockpiles, they will wage terrorism across the world. This disinformation campaign has been going on for more than 5 years now, especially since the end of the Bush era and when Obama took over. Obama has been repeatedly expressing grave concern that Pakistan is unstable. The question here is, that why is Israel the benefactor, which I wrote in my article. I wrote in my article that in case of a Pak-US war, the only benefactor will be Israel. Now, I'm not the person who said this. The person who said this is the intelligence official who I quoted, and let me reveal which department he belonged to. He belonged to the Inter-Services Intelligence. And this I'm saying with full authority. He is a senior source in my contacts, and he iterated that Pakistan does not want to fight with a zombie. America is nothing. America is just a facade which is empty inside. It is hollow. Its economy is zero. Its stock market is zero. The conditions of its people are zero. And still it is waging war, trying to feed its hungry belly with the military establishment at the top. We have General Martin Dempsey, who is General Kayani's class fellow from America, when Kayani was also a student at Fort Leavenworth, Kansas. Does he not know what kind of a person Kayani is? Yes, he does. And that is why he is still provoking Kehani. Come on, come on, react. We want you to react. Give us a response, and then we'll go in and we'll give you the crunch of your lifetime. This is what Pakistan's military establishment will not do. They will not be provoked by a silly little animal, which is currently the military establishment of America. They know that once Pakistan is engaged, then Iran will openly be attacked. Pakistan will give a proper response. The whole region will destroy itself. And at the end, I say this in strong words, the benefactor will be Israel. And this is what I confirm from my source. Because Israel has its dream of Eretz Israel, the great Israel. This can only be achieved, which Israel is already doing. The Qatar and CIA MI6 spies are destabilizing Syria, and so that they can then impede into Iran. And for that, they also are simultaneously provoking Pakistan and its military leadership. This is a proper, full-fledged plan, which is known as the great game, the path toward World War III, which Pakistan will not allow to initiate. Someone else might start it. Maybe America might start it. Pakistan will not be the one to start it. Yes, Pakistan might be the one to finish it.